our Eucharistic celebration.
We gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, today being a Saturday, we honor the Blessed Virgin Mary in this Eucharistic celebration. And let us ask her prayers and intercession, especially for those who are sick, that through her prayer, the Lord may extend to the sick His healing power. To prepare ourselves for this Eucharistic celebration, let us humbly ask God's pardon and mercy for our sins. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You are the Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, Lord God, that we, your servants, may rejoice in unfailing health of mind and body. And through the glorious intercession of Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, may we be set free from present sorrow and come to enjoy eternal happiness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Micah. Woe to those who plan iniquity and work out evil on their couches. In the morning light they accomplish it, when it lies within their power. They covet fields and seize them. Houses, they take them. They cheat an owner of his house, a man of his inheritance. Therefore, thus says the Lord, behold, I am planning against this race an evil, from which you shall not withdraw your necks, nor shall you walk with a head high, for it will be a time of evil. And that day as a tire shall be sung over you, and there shall be a plaintive chant. Our ruin is complete. Our fields are portioned out among our captors. The fields of my people are measured out, and no one can get them back. Thus you shall have no one to mark out boundaries by lot in the assembly of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Do not forget the poor, O Lord.
Do not forget the poor, O Lord.
Why, O Lord, do you stand aloof? Why hide in times of distress? Proudly the wicked harass the afflicted who are caught in the devices the wicked have contrived.
Do not forget the poor, O Lord.
For the wicked man glories in his greed, and the covetous blasphemes sets the Lord at naught. The wicked man boasts, he will not avenge it. There is no God, sums up his thoughts.
Do not forget the poor, O Lord.
His mouth is full of cursing, guile and deceit. Under his tongue are mischief and iniquity. He lurks in ambush near the villages, in hiding the murderers, the innocent. His eyes spy upon the unfortunate.
Do not forget the poor, O Lord.
You do see, for you behold misery and sorrow, taking them in your hands. On you, the unfortunate man depends, and the fatherless, you are the helper.
Do not forget the poor, O Lord. Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The Pharisees went out and took counsel against Jesus to put him to death. When Jesus realized this, he withdrew from that place. Many people followed him, and he cured them all. But he warned them not to make him known. This was to fulfill what had been spoken through Isaiah the prophet. Behold, my servant whom I have chosen, my beloved in whom I delight. I shall place my spirit upon him, and he will proclaim justice to the Gentiles. He will not contend or cry out, nor will anyone hear his voice in the streets. A bruised reed he will not break, a smoldering wick he will not quench, until he brings justice to victory, and in his name the Gentiles will hope. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
My dear brothers and sisters, do you consider yourselves followers of Jesus? I'm sure you do. But my next question is this: why? Why do you follow Jesus? Why do you consider yourselves followers of Jesus? In the Gospel, it was said many people followed him. Many people followed him. Why? Because they need something. They are sick, they are hungry, they are lost. They follow Jesus because Jesus gives them what they need. And maybe we are like that sometimes. We go to church, we attend mass, because we have something that we need. We want something. Gustong makapasa sa board exam, gustong ma-approve ang visa, gustong gumaling sa sakit, kaya nagsisimba. There is nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with following Jesus because we need something, because it shows that we see Jesus as someone who can satisfy our needs. Di ba? Hindi ka naman lalapit sa isang taong alam mong walang maitutulong sa iyo eh. Hindi ka naman lalapit sa isang tao na alam mong wala ring maibibigay. Lumalapit tayo kay Jesus sapagkat may maibibigay si Jesus sa atin. But, my dear sisters and brothers, we should not follow Jesus only because we need something. We also do not follow Jesus because everything is going fine. These are people whom I sometimes call the fair weather Christians. Alagad ni Jesus, tagasunod ni Jesus, dahil ang lahat ay maganda, ang lahat ay maayos, ang lahat sa kanyang buhay ay tama. Pero kapag nagkasakit na, no? Kapag natanggal na sa trabaho, kapag dumating ang isang trahedya sa buhay niya o sa buhay ng kanyang pamilya, nandoon na ang panlalamig. I can see that sometimes, no? And this is the joke among us parish priests, no? When I was parish priest, Lord, lalo na kung may bagyo, no? Lord, wag naman sa araw ng Linggo. Wag naman sanang umulan sa araw ng Linggo. Bakit? Kasi kapag umulan sa araw ng Linggo, nawawala yung ibang Katoliko eh. No? Di ba? Kita yan eh, no? Kahit sa katedral eh, pag malakas ang ulan, wala halos tao. Yun yung fair weather Christians. Sumusunod dahil maganda ang panahon. Sumusunod dahil maayos ang buhay. But, my dear sisters and brothers, it will not always be like that. Life will not always be smooth. Life will not always be in accordance to what we want. But still, do we follow Jesus? My dear brothers and sisters, Mary is our model of following. Mary is our model of discipleship. She followed Jesus no matter what. She followed Jesus during joyful days. She followed Jesus even during sorrowful days. And now, she is still following Jesus in glorious days. Let us not be fair weather Christians. Let us not only follow Jesus because we need something. Let us follow Jesus because we know that our life will not be complete without Him. Amen.
Please stand.
Let us turn to God, our merciful Father, who never turns his back on the poor and those in need. To every petition, our response would be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church may be seen as the home of the weak and the poor. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who hold public office may truly render service to their constituents in the right spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That consecrated persons may dedicate their whole lives to God and to the church through their witness of life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may look with compassion and understanding to those who suffer and those who are ill. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dead may experience your saving power, O God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Merciful Father, make us true servants and followers of your love. May we become more and more like your Son, who came to serve and not to be served. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and fruit of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Please stand.
Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
May the humanity of your only begotten Son come, O Lord, to our aid. And may He, who at his birth from the Blessed Virgin did not diminish but consecrated her integrity by taking from us now our wicked deeds, make our oblation acceptable to you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds in the exaltation of all the saints, and especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo her thankful hymn of praise. For truly, even to earth's ends, you have done great things and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you look on the lowliness of your handmaid, you gave us, through her, the author of our salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, the hosts of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray as Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our many sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. As we receive this heavenly sacrament, we beseech, O Lord, your mercy, that we who rejoice in commemorating the Blessed Virgin Mary may, by imitating her, serve worthily the mystery of our redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.